center. Okay, we have someone from a very popular organization. Yeah, a much in demand organization nowadays. I first had my encounter with Tesla when I joined the IT BPM industry. Yeah, and we really had many ways and interventions of bridging the gaps, right? And I know you're working well also on other industries, not only the IT BPM. So we are lucky to have here today a graduate of Bachelor of Arts in Broadcast Communication, and his career as a content writer and instructional designer for the DESTA online program in 2017 is just among his accomplishments. This role allowed him to leverage his creativity and communication skills to design engaging and effective e-learning materials. In 2019, he was assigned as the focal personnel for the development of e-learning materials for the e-TESTA division of the NITESD. You have to explain that to us later. It's an acronym. Since then, he has played a pivotal role in leading the development of e-learning materials for various technical vocational education and training, TVET, programs and qualifications. We are honored to have here with us today a resource person who will share with us TESTA online program, Making TVET More Inclusive Through Moodle. We have Mr. Billy Andrew B. Benaflor, TESTA Specialist 2, National Institute for Technical Education and Skills Development, eTESTA Division, NITSD eTESTA. And before he starts speaking, yeah, Benaflor is a Spanish word. Yeah. Bena is good, and Flor is a flower. Okay, so let's welcome him with a round of applause.
All right, thank you. And I would like to thank Nefila for inviting us once again. So I think this is our third time to be presenting in Moodle Mood Philippines. So it's a pleasure for TESTA to be able to share our practices in making TVET inclusive and accessible for the Filipinos. So before I proceed, I would like to acknowledge my colleague, Mr. Jerwin Rodriguez. He's with me today. So yeah, and as mentioned by our MC, we are from the eTESDA NITSD. So that's just one of the many acronyms that TESDA will or TESDA has. So the NITSD stands for the National Institute for Technical Education and Skills Development, and we are from the eTESDA division specifically. So that division is the Office of Primary Responsibility for the maintenance and operation of the TESDA online program. So that includes the development of e-learning materials, maintenance of the e-learning management or of the learning management system, and providing support to external clients, as well as providing support to public tech institutions that conduct their blended and online programs in the TOP. So for this presentation, we will look into how TESDA harnessed the features and potentials of Moodle to make technical vocational education and training, or TVET, more inclusive for Filipinos. That includes utilizing the offline capability of the Moodle mobile application and integrating accessibility tools for Moodle courses to make it more accessible for learners with hearing and visual impairments. But before we proceed to those topics, we would like to provide you a quick overview or a recap of what TOP is and how has it been in the last few years. So the TESDA online program, or TOP, started in 2012 as a web-based platform for massive open online courses or MOOCs for TVET. As of June 2023, the TOP has recorded more than 4 million registered users, more than 5 million course enrollments, and 3 million plus completers. It also currently offers 155 courses for free. So in 2020, the TOP has also served as one of the primary ways for TESDA to continuously provide its services during the lockdowns imposed because of the COVID-19. So maybe during those times that we're locked at home, you've heard through social media or through television news about the Tasamanya program. So in the same year, dahil nga due to the publicity that the TOP has received from different media organizations, the TOP experienced a surge of users, prompting the agency to migrate the platform to a cloud-based server. So since it was established, the TOP has been making TVET accessible to more Filipinos through its MOOCs. So before, TOP just caters to Filipinos who are willing to take TVET courses or programs but are unable to attend face-to-face training programs. However, in 2021, TESDA brought its commitment to making TVET more inclusive through the TOP to a higher level by developing the multi-regional TESDA online program. So this is what Mr. Max Esprit was pertaining to yesterday. The migration of the due to the migration of the TOP to the cloud-based server due to the surge of users, as well as to the customization of the TOP to house the different public technical institutions in the Philippines. So now, aside from offering massive open online courses to everyone with a working email address, the TOP is also being used by the different TESDA technology institutions, as what we call them. So, in conducting blended and online training programs. At the same time, the TOP also developed the TOP mobile application utilizing the branded Moodle app and enhanced 7 of our courses to include accessibility tools. So, these innovations were launched to the public in June last year. So, 1 year after, here we are presenting the TOP mobile application. So the TOP mobile application is a result of the findings we had in our latest user survey, where it turned out that a big majority of our users use their mobile phones in accessing our online courses. So with the help of the Nephila Web Technology Inc., we developed the TOP application. But in order for us to fully utilize, and for our learners as well, to fully utilize the benefits of the mobile app, we had to ensure that our materials and our courses are mobile adaptive and can be saved for offline use. So to do that, we did some of the following. So first is the optimization of all our instructional videos. Since we want, since before we have our videos uploaded to YouTube before we link it or embed it to our courses. But for the learners, or to enable learners to save them for offline use, we have to upload them directly to our own LMS or to our server. So, and in order to avoid burdening the learners from storage or large storage that those videos might consume, we have to optimize our videos before we upload them to our courses. Next week, and in relation to that, we also migrated the videos from YouTube to the TOP. Then we also check the mobile compatibility of H5P interactive activities and resources, since there are activities and resources in H5P that may not be that effective if using mobile devices such as mobile phones and tablets. And lastly, ensuring that visual and interactive learning materials are mobile adaptive, so that the images that we will upload will adjust whenever a learner uses a mobile phone, when he or she uses a mobile tablet, or when he or she uses a desktop or a laptop computer. Now, to test the usability of the TOP mobile application, we conducted a test among the learners of the TOP MOOCs. So through this test, we intended to gauge the experience of learners in downloading of the mobile application and the online and offline use of the TOP courses, identify the challenges experienced in the downloading of the mobile app and the TOP courses for online and offline use, and identify recommendations and rooms for improvement based on the overall experience of our respondents. So through the usability test, users of the TOP mobile application were asked to rate the usability of the application in terms of ease of downloading the courses, ease of use, and ease of synchronizing their progress when they use the mobile app for offline access and when they connect to the online server. So they were asked to rate the app based on these factors from 1 to 4, with 4 being the highest. And the results show that for the respondents, using the app is generally easy. So we can see that out of 4. In terms of ease of download, they rated the app, they gave the app a 2.94. Then in terms of ease of use, they gave it a 2.99. And ease of synchronization, they gave it a 2.99 as well. However, the result also shows that there's still a big room for improvement. Diba? So, aside from that, the TOP users also provided what for them is the biggest challenge that they face in accessing the TOP using the mobile app. So first and foremost, same with what has been surfacing in our discussions starting yesterday, the problems in internet connectivity. Since even though the TOP mobile app enables learners to access the courses offline, they still have to connect to the internet in order to save the courses. So that's where the problems in internet connectivity comes in. Furthermore, in the second spot is the registration issue. So there's a problem with how they encounter problems in logging into the application. So some have forgotten their usernames and passwords since many of our users just have these information saved when the first time they log in using their mobile phone. So when they transition to accessing the TOP using the mobile app, they're not able to remember what those informations were. And so on, we also have the lack of mobile device to use, lack of mobile phone memory, lack of instructions on how to use the app, navigation issues, difficulty in setting up the app, and no Google Play or iOS accounts. So these are the challenges that the respondents of the usability test encountered in accessing the TOP mobile application. So with these findings, the ETESDA NITSD is currently working towards the following ways forward. So first is the recommendation of the use of the TOP mobile app as an alternative to the browser-based access of the TESDA online program. So we are currently capacitating the different TESDA technology institutions. We are making them familiar of the potential of the TOP mobile app in letting their learners take the e-learning materials at home and access them without internet connection. Then, improve the course structures to enhance compatibility with the TOP mobile app. So we are looking for ways on how to make the courses even shorter, to make them easier for the learners to download, and for them to easier for them to complete even when they're at home. Next, continuously monitor feedback from users to improve on issues reported. So this is what we think is the most important ways forward that we have, is to continuously check on the users, how they see or how they are able to use the TOP mobile application in order for us to identify other ways to improve the mobile application that we currently offer. So that is one of the ways TESDA makes the VET more inclusive through Moodle. But as Itbulaga says, wait, there's more. So in 2021, aside from customizing the TOP for multi-regional implementation and developing the TOP mobile application, TESDA also enhanced seven of its courses to incorporate accessibility features, namely screen reader compatibility, audio narration, and Filipino sign language insets. So to do this, we hired developers who have expertise in developing e-learning materials that are accessible for learners with hearing and visual impairments. So coincidentally, the experts that we hired also experienced these impairments as well, and they themselves know what should be or what is needed in order for the courses to be accessible for learners like them. So first, we started with the evaluation of existing courses to determine what accessibility features should be integrated. Since we have the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines 2.1, we conducted the evaluation according to the requirements of the WCAG 2.1 and 2C. Where we currently are and what needs to be done in order to go to the next level. So after the evaluation, it turned out that our existing courses are just compliant with single A. So WCAG has three levels of compliance po. So it's from single A to triple A. So the previous version of the courses that we had is just single A compliant. And we decided that we want to make it, if not triple A, we want to make it double A compliant. So we had to decide, in order to do that, we had to decide which accessibility features needs to be incorporated into these courses. And according to the expert opinion of the developers that we hired, these three are some of the main features that must be present in order for us to meet that requirement or to be compliant on that WCAG compatibility level. So we have the compatibility with screen reader applications, with availability, with available audio narration for instructional videos, and with Filipino Sign Language insets. So we proceeded with the integration of these accessibility tools, and afterwards, we tested the courses among selected users to see if we were able to attain our goal before launching the courses to the public. And thankfully, we had users with hearing and when we had users with hearing and visual impairments take the courses, they rated them that these courses were thankfully WCAG double A compliant. So there. Currently, these are the numbers of the users who have enrolled and completed these courses. So as you can see, the courses that we enhanced for learners with to include accessibility features for learners with hearing and visual impairments are courses under Bread and Pastry Production NC2 and Food Processing NC2. So these are existing courses, existing TOP courses. We just enhanced them in order to incorporate the accessibility features that we want. There. So what did we learn in doing these enhancements? So after incorporating the changes, we were able to identify the following measures as must-dos to ensure that courses are accessible and inclusive. So moving forward, since we want to make the courses more accessible, even though there will be no specific features such as the sign language insets, the audio narrations, we can ensure that courses are accessible even at the most basic level by doing these things. So first, use closed captions in instructional videos. So before we were, when we started developing instructional videos, we were made aware that we had to include subtitles, hard-coded subtitles. However, these elements does not enable learners to enable or disable them whenever they like. So instead of using hard-coded subtitles, we opted to using closed captions. That way, learners can enable or disable these features. And also, if the learner is using audio screen reader applications, the screen reader can also read or cover that part of the course. Next, ensure screen reader compatibility. So this includes using image descriptions for the visual materials. As we see, to those who have been developing courses in Moodle, whenever you upload an image, there's a text box for image description. So the list that we can do to make sure that our courses are accessible for learners with hearing and visual impairments is to provide the description of those images so that whenever they take the courses using their screen reader applications, the screen reader application can provide them the description of the image. Next, this also includes avoiding the use of in-image texts as they cannot be accessed by screen reader applications. So before we've also been guilty of this. We develop infographics, so we incorporate texts with images and upload them as just a single image. So now that we found out that, now that we've been more aware that we must also cater to learners with hearing and visual impairments, we avoid that using that kind of visuals anymore, and instead opted to use in direct text in courses instead of in-image ones. Next, explore low bandwidth solutions. So this includes optimizing instructional videos and multimedia materials to allow them to be downloaded for offline use easier. Next, keeping courses short and bite-sized, and determining contents that must use instructional videos carefully. So as much as possible, we want to make the courses as light as it can be, so learners will be able to save them for offline use as easy and with most minimal bandwidth connection required as possible. Lastly, familiarize ourselves with and utilize the accessibility features of Moodle and H5P. So as Ms. Marie Ashour mentioned yesterday, Moodle observes international standards and on website accessibility. In fact, Moodle has achieved compliance to Web Content Accessibility Guidelines level AA in 2020. So this means that Moodle allows users to enlarge text by zooming in, read the text and view images that have a high contrast to their background, change the background and text color and fonts using browser plugins, navigate the website using only keyboard, navigate using a screen reader and speech recognition software, and listen to text and image descriptions using a screen reader. So these features are a good like building block or a good platform for us to build up on in order for us to ensure that the courses that we will develop through Moodle is accessible. So there, those are the current interventions or innovations that TESDA develops and applies in order to ensure that TVET remains inclusive and accessible for everyone. And if you have further queries or if you want more information, you can visit TESDA Online Program. We have the website here, www.e-testa.gov.ph, and we also have our email address there, so testa.program@testa.gov.ph. So should you have further requirements for information, feel free to contact us or visit our website. So thank you everyone, and I hope you learned something from this presentation.
Yeah, definitely, Mr. Billy, Andrew, when a floor. Okay, so do we have questions from the audience? TESDA is a much in demand training service provider. In fact, it's a mandate for them to provide, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and all we need to do is reach out to them. Yeah, there are a lot of ways and interventions that they can help us with when it comes to our challenges. Sir, yes.
I might have a question. Sir, since you have a handed class module developed on our courses, so may I know regarding the video storage, are you uploading on a third party or the upload is directly uploading on the courses?
Sir, just like I've mentioned before we opted to making the courses available for offline, we were uploading the videos to YouTube. But when we decided that we want the courses, the entire course, to be accessible for the learners offline, we decided to upload the videos direct to our LMS. So there, sir.
Are you good?
Storage.
The storage, maybe Sir Jerwin can provide further details about the storage. So we use an S3 server for the video, so it uses a big storage. So. But we, in order for us to save, we make sure that the videos are kept in below 3 minutes. So we keep it as short as possible to make sure that not that big of a storage will be consumed with it by this video. So. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Are you good with that? Okay. How about you? Do you have any questions? Oh, goodness. Okay. Thank you. Yeah. So, I have a different question, sir. It's not in your presentation, but in your profile, it says that you actively participated in training trainers.
Yes.
Right? So, what have been your challenges in training trainers in terms of, you know, selecting, determining competencies, potentials, and yeah, can you share with us?
Yeah, I think it's just a lucky coincidence that even before the pandemic struck us, we've started developing the competency standards for facilitating e-learning sessions. So this competency standards lists down the competencies required for a TEVA trainer to conduct e-learning sessions. So this includes pure online and even blended learning sessions. So for TESDA, I think it has been mandatory for every trainer to undergo facilitate e-learning sessions training before they can teach. Since just like what every presenter has before me has said, doing trainings in a flexible modality is here to stay. So it's a proactive measure to make sure that each and every trainer of TESDA, both existing in the organization and the upcoming ones, will be trained in facilitating e-learning sessions. Of course, the first time we run the program, it wasn't easy for everyone or for some, since not all trainers is that adept in using the technologies that is required in order to conduct e-learning sessions. But along the way, with consistent assistance and provision of technical support, I hope we were able to provide the necessary training, and we will be able to continuously provide the necessary assistance for our trainers as well.
That's good to hear, Sir Billy. So we request you to stay, and we request Max SP once again to hand the certificate of appreciation to Mr. Billy Andrew Benaflor of TESDA, and as a sign of our gratitude for his invaluable sharing of knowledge and expertise today here at the Century Park Hotel Manila, Budamut, Philippines 2023 Conference. Big round of applause.